we were so curious to see what happened, what would happen. You know, we've been out on tour and it worked great, we had great chemistry. What would happen if we went in the studio? What would we create? What would be
actually
new?
Actually make music,
And it's been a thrilling time, really has. We've created in various ways, haven't we, really?
And, you know, and often I hear people, they say, you know, why are you still doing this kind of thing? Well, it's what we do, you know. You know, if you're a doctor, you know, it's what you do, isn't it? And so why would you stop doing it, you know? That's work is good for you.
It's a great evolution taking place in the studio because we knew we could do it on tour last time. Well, at the end of the tour we did. But we didn't know if we could create new material together, and it just seems to have fallen into place. We've tried all kinds of different situations with each other, and we've worked on each other's material, and it feels like a group. It feels kind of like a new group with a relation to the old groups.
Yes, definitely.
But a fantastic, a very exciting situation to create in. It's been amazing.
The first session really was a complete groping in the dark at first, wasn't it? I mean, I think Paul came up with some ideas that were floating around in his head, and we just worked on those mainly at first, and then I think...
I think it's true. It's fair to say that we still don't have a set way of working, particularly.
No.
Sometimes
no.
It would end up with me on an acoustic guitar and Roger on the kit, and we would lay a demo down, and then Brian would immediately rush out there, all excited, right, and blast something on, and we'd just build the track from that. Maybe I'm on the piano.
A lot of it was based on live stuff, which is great. We actually did play right here an enormous amount, just playing, just trying stuff out and seeing where it goes.
Sparking off each other.
Improvised stuff. And Paul would come up with... Actually, Paul had a lot of ideas in his head, and we would just gradually... And he'd say, how about this? And by the time we'd run it through twice, Roger and I were sort of picking up. And we have a couple of takes, which were second or third take, which have survived. And that's a rarity. You don't often get albums these days that are actual musicians playing together and firing off each other. So we're kind of proud of that. And it gives a fantastic organic core to this album. There's a reality. It's not like cooked up. It's not sampled and stitched on. It's people playing together and feeling something.
That's true. But having said that, we've got all of the latest technology at our fingertips as well.
Yep.
So it's really a combination of both things.
I would tend to make demos and bring them in, and if the guys sort of, we'd fire off an idea that people liked, you know, it's a slightly different way of doing it. But that's one of the different ways of doing it. Mm. But we're lucky here. We've got everything here at our fingertips in our workspace.
So we do a lot of eating.
Yeah, we eat well.
A little bit of drinking, but mainly eating.
Yeah.
A little bit of work. Lots of
discussion.
Bit of work
down again.
Much discussion, which has been great.
I came in with as open a mind as I could, you know. I mean, it's very easy to fall into a sort of a habitual way of doing things. But it's very enlightening when, for me anyway, when I come into the studio with an open mind and Brian will suggest doing it, and I'll think we're doing it a different way, and I'll say, well, I've never quite sung it that way before, but okay, I'll try it. And it will work, you know. We'll do different techniques in the studio for recording, which I won't reveal because they're secrets. But,
When you were singing in that bottle...
You know, but it's been a huge learning curve as well for me. It's been very interesting, and it is very much a combination of our, the music, the sounds that we have tended to make in the past. It's very much a combination of the two things, isn't it?
Definitely, I feel the same.
It's very unique.
It's very good when a team of three sort of arrive at something by push-pull here and then we usually seem to arrive at something quite good.
Yeah, it's fascinating. Yeah, I feel the same as Paul, definitely. You know, the places we could never have gone if it weren't for the fact that there's three of us here all with different little influences and experiences and stuff. It's been very interactive. Mm. Yeah, it's a very colourful album, I would say.
Yeah.
Many, many different directions in there.
Yeah.
Which reflects some of our backgrounds and a great blending together of our different...
There's some very good, nice, organic, live bluesy stuff there as well, which I feel is also very much at the heart of the album.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
mm-hmm. Yeah.
Stuff that was played absolutely live in the studio, and so that happened.
Yeah, and then some fantasies of production, which we like. You know, we've always, Roger and I certainly have always been into.
Yeah.
Well, it's a strange thing. It just sort of appeared before us, didn't it, really? It gradually evolved, this idea that it became sort of spacey and slightly, I suppose, sort of retro space-agey, some of the concepts that we were kicking around. And it just grew, and things have become more and more wacky. And it's a pretty spacey album, isn't it now, really?
Parts of it are. Each song, no two songs are in any way similar. They're all very different, aren't they?
That's right.
And I love the title because I think, you know, the future of mankind, really, both you know, physically and spiritually, is kind of, you know, out there in space. I hope that's not too cosmic, but it's kind of true.
Yeah, and you know, I mean, Brian's got a big connection with obviously with his astronomical connections and
oh, they are, they're huge.
And, you know, the huge connections. there's a little tie in there. And I just like the idea of.
Yes,
creation is wonderful, you know. Mm-hmm. It's basically a little play on that as well, you know.
It's nice, and I think it reminds. It's nice for us to remind people that basically we want to entertain them. You know, yes, we want to do all kinds of stuff. We want to do exploration and experimentation, and maybe want to sometimes make people think a little. But basically, we're entertainers, and we love to give people a great time and take them someplace they'd never been before, and put big smiles on their faces. I think there'll be a lot of smiles from this album. It's a lot of fun.
The way the media is different now, I think it's more complicated, you know. You know, there's the whole of the internet and the downloading and all the different types of you know, forms of release of things, it's more complicated than it used to be,
I mean, you know, I've said this before, but I mean, technology is constantly exploding, you know. What is brand new this week is old-fashioned next week, and so many things change in the music business in those terms, like you say, in terms of how people receive their music, you know, whether it's a download, whether it's this, that, or that. But what always remains the same is that the music has to have that feeling, you know, and I think that's what we definitely, that's what we've got going on here. It's just a great sort of coming together of energies, and it's very creative. That's the key to it all.
Mm. I sometimes wonder if, like with the iPods and things, if people are really hearing a full range of, the full spectrum of music, you know. I don't think that the quality of people's home equipment is really quite as good as it used to be in some ways, and you know, so it has differed. In I wonder if the fidelity is quite the same, but you know,
a lot of changes in the business. I mean,
it's become a little, almost a little too electronic and processed for me. I do like some knobbly edges on things, some gnarly edges, you know, some
like a bit of vinyl crackle.
Real emotion, you know, and regardless of one or two where you reach for it and maybe, you know, you don't quite make it or whatever. But, you know, the thing is that you're reaching for something all the time.
Yeah.
Yeah.